Hello everyone, this is Kanimoli from Agricultural Biotechnology Department, Bharat Institute of Higher Education Research. Today we are going to discuss on carbohydrates. So you can see the structure of carbohydrate here is containing carbon, hydrogen, oxygen. Okay, so carbohydrates means it's containing carbon, hydrogen and oxygen. So introduction. So what is carbohydrates? Carbohydrates are hydrates of carbon. Carbohydrates are hydrates of carbon. It's having the empirical formula of CH2ON. So what the empirical formula of carbohydrate is? CH2ON and some carbohydrates, okay, which do not possess CH2ON, okay. So which these carbohydrates are called as non-carbohydrate, okay. So what are the example for non-carbohydrate is lactic acid. So lactic acid having the empirical formula of CH2ON, okay. And what's the proper definition for carbohydrate is chemically defined as polyhydroxyaldehyde or ketones and the derivatives and their partners. So what the proper definition for carbohydrate is, the carbohydrates are chemically defined as polyhydroxyaldehydes or ketones, the derivatives and their partners. And the carbohydrates comprise of one of the major groups of naturally occurring biomolecules, okay. So it's a macro biomolecules, okay. So carbohydrates are one of the biomolecules, the major type one, okay, compared to fat protein. So one of the carbohydrates are the major groups of naturally occurring biomolecules, okay. So for example, you can say take any dairy substance of the plants, it is containing 50 to 80% of carbohydrates, okay. So for example, you can take the dry substance, that a dried one, okay. From that it's containing 50 to 80% of carbohydrate. So structural material in plants is mainly cellulose and related hemicellulose. Okay, so what is structural component in plants of carbohydrates means, that is cellulose and hemicellulose. Starch, okay. So starch is a storage polysaccharides in plant. What is structural polysaccharide mean? That is example cellulose. Starch is a storage polysaccharide which is present in the plants. Okay. So non-carbohydrate organic molecules are found conjugated with sugars in the form of glycosides. Non-carbohydrate organic molecules. The various non-carbohydrate organic molecules. I already seen that lactic acid, right? So it is found conjugated with sugar molecule to form a glycosides. Okay. So carbohydrates in animals are mostly found in combination with protein as glycoproteins. Okay. So carbohydrate, obviously carbohydrates are present in the animals. Okay. What happened here? The carbohydrates binds with the protein main, which is called as a glycoprotein. Gly means carbohydrate proteins. Okay. Just mostly it is the carbohydrate bind with the protein, which is called as a glycoprotein. What is the storage form of carbohydrate? Okay, so glycogen is the storage form of carbohydrate in animals. Where it is present? It is present in the liver and muscles. Okay, so storage form of carbohydrates in animal is glycogen. Where it is found mean? It is found in the livers and muscles. Next one is structural form. We have already seen structural form of polysaccharide in plants is cellulose, right? So here structural formation of polysaccharides in animal is chitin. Okay, so it is comprised of polymer of N-acetyl glucosamine. Okay, so it is universally found in other polymeric substances. Okay, so fats are fatty acid, esters of sugar, alcohol, and glycerol. Ribose and deoxyribose are constituent of nucleic acid. So these are the compounds having carbohydrate group. Okay, so ribose comes under the category of carbohydrate here. Okay, so it's a universal. Okay, so universally found in other polymeric substances. And for example, you can say adenosine triphosphate, that is ATP. In short form, you can say it is ATP, adenosine triphosphate. So it's a ribose as a constituent. Okay, so ribose is one of the carbohydrate key substance. Okay, so here adenosine ATP is a key substance in energy storage and transfer. Okay, so next, carbon skeletons of all organic molecules are derived from the carbohydrates. So you can see various carbon skeletons molecules are there. So these carbon skeletons are organic molecules are derived from carbohydrates. Okay, so there are basic raw materials of many important industries. Okay, so sugar industries, starch industries, paper and wood pulp industries, textiles industries, plastic, food processing industries, and fermentation industries require some of the raw material from the carbohydrate only. So sugar and sugar product, glucose obviously, you know, starch product, you know, most of the things having starch, okay? So which is paper and wood pulp that having carbohydrate, textile and plastic that should necessary because there is carbohydrate. Food processing, we need carbohydrate. Fermentation process, we need carbohydrate. So some of the basic raw materials are derived from the carbohydrate for many industries. So next one, we are going to see about the classification. So there are three types of carbohydrates are there. One is monosaccharides, oligosaccharides, and polysaccharides. Monosaccharides, oligosaccharides, and polysaccharides. First, so in this table, you can see the difference between the monosaccharides, oligosaccharides, and polysaccharides. Okay. So what is monosaccharide? It's a low molecular weight compound. So it's a simple sugar. Okay. So it's a low molecular weight compound. But in the case of oligosaccharides, means it's containing 2 to 10 monosaccharides, which is joined by glycosidic bond. Okay. So here what happened? These glycosidic bond plays a major role to join, to bind one monosaccharide to another monosaccharide. Okay. So it's containing 2 to 10 monosaccharides. What about the polysaccharides? It's containing many monosaccharides. That is more than 10 monosaccharides, which is also joined by glycosidic bond. Okay. And it cannot. Okay. So this monosaccharide cannot be hydrolyzed further because the monosaccharide is simple sugar. So we could not hydrolyze. Okay. But in the case of oligosaccharide, what happened? It's a low molecular weight carbohydrate, which can be hydrolyzed by enzyme or acids to yield a monosaccharide. Okay. So it's a low molecular weight carbohydrate. Okay, so you can hydrolyze the oligosaccharide with the help of enzymes or acids to yield a monosaccharide. They can be hydrolyzed, that is polysaccharide. Polysaccharide also hydrolyzed by enzymes or acids. Finally, it produces monosaccharide, oligosaccharides, disaccharides, etc. Okay, so what's the formation? Okay, so it is a crystalline in nature. Okay, monosaccharides are crystalline in nature, but in the case of oligosaccharides, powdery or crystalline. Okay, this is also polysaccharides are powdery or crystalline. I couldn't mention more. Okay, and what about the solubility? Okay, monosaccharides are soluble in water, oligosaccharides also soluble in water, but polysaccharides are insoluble in water. Okay, so next one is taste. Okay, what is the taste of monosaccharide? Okay. It is taste one. Okay. For example, you can say the glucose. We know very well that glucose is sweet. Okay. So next, oligosaccharide also sweet in taste. But in the case of polysaccharide is one tasteless. Okay. And so there are two type of polysaccharide available. One is it may be linear or it may be a branched one. Another differentiation between monosaccharide, oligosaccharide, and polysaccharide is classification. Okay, so the monosaccharides are classified into triose, tetrose, pentose, hexose, and heptose, depending upon number of carbon atoms. Okay, so here the classification based on number of carbon atoms. Triose means 3. It containing 3 carbon atoms. Tetrose means it containing 4 carbon atoms. Pentose means it's containing 5 carbon atoms. Hexose means it's containing 6. Heptose means 7 carbon atom. So totally, it is fully based upon the number of carbon atom. Okay. Another classification also there in the monosaccharide, that is, it may be either aldoses or ketoses. Here, how the classification they made means based upon the presence of aldehyde group and ketone group. If aldehyde group are present, means that is called as an aldosis. If keto group are present, means that is called as a ketosis. So next, move on to the oligosaccharides. Okay, so these oligosaccharides are classified into disaccharide, trisaccharide, tetrasaccharide, and pentasaccharide. So it is based upon the number of carbohydrates they contain. Okay, how many monosaccharides are present? Okay, so here the classification is based upon the number of monosaccharides contained. Okay, so it's classified into disaccharide, tri, tetra, and penta. What about the polysaccharide? So polysaccharides are classified into homopolysaccharide and heteropolysaccharide. So here it's based upon the kind of monosaccharides. Okay, so if same monosaccharides are present, means it is comes under homosaccharide. Different monosaccharides are present, means it is called as a heteropolysaccharide. Different means glucose, fructose, like that. Okay, homopoly, click on for this. Or same polysaccharides means what happened? Same na, that is glucose, and glucose alone should be present. Okay, that is homopolysaccharides. Next one is water. So next classification of polysaccharide is depending based upon the function. Okay, so based upon the storage function, it is classified various comes under storage polysaccharide and structural polysaccharide. We already seen the introduction of the carbohydrate. Storage polysaccharide for animals is water. That is glycogen. Structural polysaccharide for animal is chitin. Storage polysaccharide for plant is starch. Structural polysaccharide cellulose. Okay, so it is based upon the function. Okay, so next, what about the reducing property? Okay, so monosaccharides are reducing in nature, so it is called as a reducing sugar. All monosaccharides having the reducing property, so it is also called as reducing sugar. But only oligosaccharides. So oligosaccharides, some of them are reducing, some of them are non-reducing. Okay, so based upon the presence of anomeric carbon atoms. Okay, so here in the polysaccharide, non-reducing in nature, and it give deep blue color or red color. If it is deep blue color will appear when you add the iodine, mean that is called as amylose. If red color formed when you add iodine, that is amylopectin. So here polysaccharides are non-reducing sugar. Monosaccharides are all reducing sugar. Oligosaccharides some reducing sugar, and some of them are non-reducing sugar. But in the case of polysaccharides, it is non-reducing in nature. So this is the differentiation between the monosaccharide, oligosaccharide, and polysaccharide. So we will see in detail about monosaccharide. Okay, so it's a simplest sugar. We already seen simple sugar. Okay, and we could not hydrolyzed. Okay, further into smaller unit. And this monosaccharide divided into two types. That is simple monosaccharide and derived monosaccharide. So simple monosaccharide are further classified as based upon the type of functional group. We already seen that is aldoses and ketoses, and this is one divided based upon the number of carbon atoms. Triose, tetrose, pentose, hexose, we have seen already. So these are all simple monosaccharide classification. What about the derived monosaccharides? Here the derivatives of simple monosaccharides: oxidation, reduction products, substitution products, and esters. Okay, so the derived monosaccharide means this is derivatives from the simple monosaccharides. Okay, so next. Classification of monosaccharide, aldoses and ketoses. Okay, this is fully based upon the presence of aldehyde group and ketone group. Okay, so triose means what? Aldose, ketose. Okay, so triose means what? It containing three formant. So for example, for aldoses is glycerose. What about the ketose example? Dihydroxyacetone. Next one is tetrose. Tetrose means it containing four carbon atom. So it containing four carbon atom. For a tetrose example, for aldose is erythrose. Ketose example for tetrose is erythrolose. Erythrose. Pentose means it's containing five carbon atom. So example for aldose is ribose and xylose. Okay. So for ketose it is ribulose and xylulose. Okay. So hexose means what? It containing six carbon atom. Okay, it's containing six carbon atom. So example for aldoses, D-glucose, D-galactose, and D-mannose. Okay, for example for ketoses, D-fructose. So next one is keptose. Keptose means what? It containing seven carbon atom. So example for keptose is cetokeptose, cetokeptulose. Okay, so next we move on to the oligosaccharides. So it contains 2 to 10 monosaccharide units. Okay, we already seen oligosaccharide means what? It containing 2 to 10 monosaccharide units, which is joined by glycosidic linkage. So glycosidic linkage involved for connection, that is bond between one monosaccharide to another monosaccharide. So this bond is called as a glycosidic bond, glycosidic linkage, and it can easily hydrolyze by enzyme or acids. Okay, so again this oligosaccharide classified into 4 types: disaccharides, trisaccharides, tetrasaccharides, pentasaccharides, based upon the number of the monosaccharides are present. Di means 2, tri means 3, tetra means 4, penta means 5. Disaccharides means it's containing 2 monosaccharide. Trisaccharides means it's containing 3 monosaccharides. Tetra means it's containing 4 monosaccharide. Penta means it's containing 5 monosaccharides. Okay. So now we are going to see about disaccharides. Okay. So here what? Di means 2. 2 monosaccharides joined covalently by an ortho glycosidic bond. Okay. So here there are 2 types of disaccharides available. One is reducing disaccharide and is non-reducing disaccharide. So reducing disaccharide, example, maltose and lactose. Okay. So but in the case of monosaccharide, I couldn't tell reducing monosaccharide and non-reducing one. Why? Mean because all the monosaccharides are reducing sugar. Okay. So here there are 2 types, one is reducing and non-reducing. So reducing disaccharide, example, maltose, lactose. What about the non-reducing disaccharide, example is trihalose and sucrose. So here the glycosidic linkage, how what the glycosidic linkage will occur. Okay. So hydroxyl group present in one of the monosaccharide, which is react with any one of the hydro groups attached to carbon 1, carbon 2, carbon 3, carbon 4 or carbon 6. Of another monosaccharide to produce the linkage of 1:1 glycosidic linkage, 1:2 glycosidic linkage, 1:3 glycosidic linkage, 1:4 glycosidic linkage, and 1:6 glycosidic linkages. Okay, so here this 1:1 indicate means the first carbon atom of the hydroxyl group. This one indicate the first carbon atom of the hydroxyl group. Here 1:2 means 1 is the first carbon atom of the hydroxyl group. 2 indicate that second carbon atoms of the hydroxyl group. Okay. So reducing and non-reducing disaccharide. What is reducing disaccharide? So reducing disaccharide means here only one anomeric carbon is involved in the glycosidic bond formation, which is called the reducing disaccharide. Okay, so it is based upon the reducing property and it's also presence of anomeric carbon. So reducing only one anomeric carbon which involves the glycosidic bond formation, which is called the reducing disaccharide. If both anomeric carbon atoms are involved in glycosidic bond formation, it's called as a non-reducing disaccharide. Here I give an example of structure of disaccharide. Here you can see the disaccharide example is maltose. So maltose comes under the reducing disaccharide here. Okay, so it is made up of 2 glucose residues. This is the structure of the glucose residues, which is joined by glycosidic linkages between C1, that is carbon 1 of the glucose residue, and carbon 4 of the another glucose residue. Okay, so this is 1, this is 2. Here it is joined, the first carbon is the first carbon. Okay, here the first carbon are present. You can see this is the first carbon. Okay, so this first carbon of the hydroxyl group joined with another glucose residue of the carbon 4th hydroxyl group. Okay, so here this is the first one, this is the carbon 1, this is the carbon 2, carbon 3, this is carbon 4. Okay, so here the formation occur. Here what the linkages will occur? 1:4 glycosidic linkages occur in the maltose. So here you can see this is the alpha D glucose, this is the beta D glucose. You can see the difference. Alpha D glucose and beta D glucose means what happened? Alpha means what happened? So all that is based upon the OH group. Okay. So if the OH group just below the, if it is below means it's called the alpha. If it is above means it's called the beta D glucose. Okay. What happened on hydrolysis? Okay. On the hydrolysis process, what happened? The maltose will form. Okay. By the linkages between the C1 and C4. You can see the structure of the maltose. Here is the structure of the maltose. Another maltose, here the configuration of anomeric carbon of glucose involved in the linkage of alpha 1,4 linkage. Okay, so anomeric carbon atom, the second glucose is free, so and therefore maltose is the reducing sugar. You can see that second glucose is free, anomeric carbon of the second carbon is free. Okay, so here second carbon is free. Okay, so that's why it is called as a reducing sugar. Okay, second glucose reduces capable of existing alpha or beta configuration. So maltose is usually obtained as a product of enzyme by the hydrolysis of starch during germination or malting process. Okay, so here usually obtained, okay, so the maltase usually obtains a product of enzyme. Okay, so you can get the enzyme, you can get the maltose from the starch. Okay, so when you hydrolyze the starch and finally you got the maltose. Okay, so which when it is takes place is during the germination process or during the malting process. Okay, so here what enzyme involved mean maltase is enzyme, maltase is enzyme or used to break the maltose. Okay, so maltase, this maltose are used to degrade by the enzyme called maltase. Where it is present? It is present in the yeast. Okay, so finally what happened? It will give the two molecules of D-glucose. One is alpha D-glucose and another one is beta D-glucose. Next one is invert sugar. What is invert sugar? What is the definition for invert sugar? Means the hydrolysis of sucrose when allowed polarimetrically optical rotation from positive to negative. That is when you kept in the optical rotation, what happened? Here the changes will occur from positive to negative. That is textrotetrate to levorotetrate. Okay, so textrotetrate sucrose on hydrolysis yield levorotetrate mixture of glucose and fructose. Okay, so normally sucrose is a textrorotatory sucrose. Okay, so what happened in the hydrolysis process? It finally yield levorotatory mixture of glucose and fructose. So that's why it is called, sucrose is called as the invert sugar. Okay, so levorotation is due to presence of fructose, which is more levorotatory than textrotatory glucose. Okay, so why it is converted to levorotatory during the hydrolysis process means here the levorotatory occur due to presence of fructose, because fructose is more levorotatory and glucose is a textrotatory one. So what's the meaning of invert sugar means? For example, we can say sucrose, what happened? It is normally textrotatory. When you do the hydrolysis process, it is changed to textrotatory to levorotatory. So it is for example, they give a sucrose. Okay, sucrose is an invert sugar. Okay, so it is give a textrotatory to levorotatory. Why it is? What's the reason? Because of the presence of fructose, more amount of fructose are present in the sucrose. Okay, so next classification of carbohydrates, polysaccharide. So polysaccharide means what? It containing high molecular weight of polymers, that is containing more than 10 monosaccharides. So polysaccharide means it's containing more than 10 monosaccharides. It may be either a linear one or a branched one in structure. Okay, and it's further classified based on the kind of monosaccharide presence. Okay, so based upon the what kind of monosaccharide are present. Okay, so it is divided into homopolysaccharide and heteropolysaccharide. So homopolysaccharide means what? It is made from a single kind of monosaccharide, that is only glucose only response, only fructose only response. Okay, that is homopolysaccharide. What is heteropolysaccharide mean? It is made up of more than one type of monosaccharide, that is hemicellulose. Okay, so it may be any one of the fructose, glucose, like the two monosaccharides are responsible for the formation of heteropolysaccharides. So here this again the four polysaccharide again classified based on the function. Okay, so based on the function is divided into storage polysaccharide and structural polysaccharide. Storage polysaccharide, it is stored form of energy. So example, starch, glycogen and inulin. So starch is the example for plant, glycogen is example for the animals. Next one is structural polysaccharide. Okay, it plays the function of structural function. Okay, so example, cellulose, chitin, semicellulose. Chitin is example for the animals, cellulose and hemicellulose example for the plant. next we are going to see the starch. Okay, so we already seen starch is the example for storage form of polysaccharides in the plant. Okay, so what's the principal role of starch? Is it reserves the food in the form of polysaccharide. Okay, it's a one type of food reserved polysaccharide. It's a major source of carbohydrate in the human diet. Okay, so mostly the human diet containing starch is the one of the major source in the food. Okay, so where it is found? It is found in some protozoa, bacteria, and also algae. Okay, where it is occurs in means it is present in the seeds, fruits, leaves, tubers, and bulbs, and few percentage to over 70%. Okay, so in starch, it is in starch in the plants. Where it is present means it is occurs in the seeds, fruits, leaves, tubers, and bulbs. Okay, so what the percentage level is? From 1% to 74%. Up to 74% is present in the various parts of plants. So you can see the structure of the starch. You can see the linear structure, and it's also on the branch structure. So we will see on that. Okay, so it is a structure of starch that only we are going to see now. So it's also called as alpha glucan. Okay, so starch made up of amylose and aminopectin. So okay, starch is made up of amylose and aminopectin. Third component are referred as the intermediate fraction. Okay, so these are organized into quasi-crystalline macromolecules. Okay, so these are the material are arranged in a quasi-crystalline macromolecular aggregates called the granules. Okay, so the shape of the granules are characteristics of the source of the starch. The shape of the granules are characteristic the source of the starch. If it based upon the source, it is the shape of the granules will be appear. So amylose and amylopectin. 2% of amylose in baccirrhize or vaccine maize. Okay, so about 80% amylose in amylo maize. Okay, so while majority of the starch containing. Okay, containing 15 to 35% of amylose. 15 to 35% of amylose. So you can see the structure of the amylose here. The linkages will be occur. You can see the linkages between one first carbon and the third fourth carbon of second glucose here. All 1-4 linkages will be there. So alpha D glucose units the linear way by alpha 1-4 linkages, glycosidic linkages. Okay, so it's a linear amylose, the linear structure one. Okay, not it's not a branched one, it's a linear structure one. Here, how what the linkages will occur mean 1 to alpha 1 to 4 linkages will occur. What the molecular weight of amylose is 150,000 to 1 crore, and it's a mixture of linear molecule with limited long chain branching involving alpha 1-6 linkages. Okay, and the branch is containing several hundred of glucose residues. The one branch is containing several hundred of glucose residues, and it gives the characteristic of blue color with iodine. That is, if you're having the amylose in the in your sample, means when you add an iodine solution, what happened? It started to change the color from colorless to blue color. So it just indicates the presence of amylose in the sample. So you can see the structure of amylopectin. So this is the branched one. Here you can see the branch. Okay, so this is the branched one. So it's the branched water salt insoluble polymer. So amylopectin or branch water insoluble branch polymer. It containing thousands of D glucose residues. Okay, so the amylopectin containing thousands of D glucose residues. What the main chain of the amylopectin is D glucose. Okay, and these D glucose are joined by alpha 1-4 glycosidic bonds, and also side chain also occurs. So main chain will occur. That is main chain bond is alpha 1-4 glycosidic bond. That side chain bond is alpha 1-6 glycosidic bond. Okay. So the each chain contains 15 to 25 glucose residues, which is joined by alpha 1-4 bonds. Okay. So it's containing 94 to 96% alpha 1-4 and 4 to 6% of alpha 1% link 1-6 linkages will occur in the structure of the starch. From that we can say that the starch will be made up of the 3/4 of the structure in the amylopectin. So 3/4 of the place occupied by the linear structure one, only the 1/4 structure, only the 1/4 place only occupy the 1-4, 1-6 linkages. Okay, so what the molecular weight of amylopectin is 10^7 to 10^8. This is the molecular weight of amylopectin. So you can see the structure of starch here. You can see, okay. So this red color indicate the branch chain. Okay, so this blue color indicate the linear chain. Okay, so next, this the structure will be like this one. Okay, this is the structure of amylopectin. It's a branch starch. Okay, so you can see the structure of alpha-1-4-glycosidic. Here, where it will occur means in the branched one. Okay, so this is the linear one. So linear one means what happened? What linkages will occur? Alpha-1-4-glycosidic linkages will occur. So next, we are going to see the structural polysaccharide. We have seen storage polysaccharide. Now we are going to see the structural polysaccharide. This is the structure of the cellulose. Okay, so cellulose, the most abundant organic substances which is found in the nature. Okay, so it's a principal constituent of cell walls in higher plants. Okay, so the plants having the cell wall of the plants having cellulose. Okay, so it occurs in pure form in cotton fibers and to a lesser extent in the flax and jute and wood and cereal straws. Okay, so mostly where this occur in, 90% occur in the cotton fibers. So 80% in the flax, 60% to 70% of cellulose occur in the jute, 40% to 50% of cellulose occur in the wood, and 30% to 43% of occur in the cereal straws. Okay, and it's a linear unbranched homoglycan of 10,000 to 15,000 D-glucose joined by beta-1,4-glycolinkages. Okay, so it's a linear one, it's an unbranched homoglycan. Okay, homoglycan means what? It is containing same kind of monosaccharide. Okay, here what happened? This is, it is containing only D-glucose, not other things. Okay, so it's a linear one, unbranched one of homoglycan. So what the molecular weight of this cellulose is 10,000 to 15,000. Okay, so here these D-glucose are joined by beta-1,4 linkages. Another one is glucopyranose rings in the chair conformation. Okay, so it's a glucopyranose rings. Okay, pyranose rings structure will form the chair conformation. The most stable conformation for the polymer is the chair turned 180 degree related to the adjacent glucose residues, yielding a straight extended chain. Okay, so within the plant cell walls, it is organized into biological units of structure known as microfibrils. Okay, so that within the cell, plant cell wall, okay, within the plant cell wall, these cellulose, okay, cellulose organized into biological units called as a microfibrils. It's also bundle of cellulose molecule arranged with this long axis panel, okay, with a long axis panel. Okay, so this is the small introduction about some of the carbohydrates. So carbohydrates are classified into three types: monosaccharide, disaccharide, and polysaccharide. So oligosaccharide and polysaccharide. So monosaccharide is a simple sugar. Oligosaccharide means it's containing 2 to 10 monosaccharides. Polysaccharide is containing more than 10 monosaccharides. Okay. In the hydrolysis process, mean we could not hydrolyze the simple sugar, that is monosaccharide. We can hydrolyze the oligosaccharides and polysaccharides. Okay. So this is the small introduction of the carbohydrate. Thank you.